My name is Serena Houghton. This is the University of Massachusetts Amherst. And I'm a doctoral student and working for Dr. Bertone-Johnson. So I'm in the Department of Biostatistics and Epidemiology. I'm an epidemiology PhD. My specific research is currently on PMS and macronutrients. I really liked nutritional epidemiology, and it's really fun to work on women's health things. So yeah, I've always been interested in science, although originally I thought it might be paleontology that I liked. So I went to a math and science academy, Magnet Academy. You got to take different science classes that they normally don't have in different high schools. So like I took a meteorology class, geology, astronomy, and then the regular sciences as well. I've always liked math and science, and so I started with a public health degree and a master's in public health, and then decided I wanted to do research, so I continued on. Because I liked the math, and I liked actually like figuring out the puzzles and figuring out what the different recommendations could be.
Dairy napkins to diaphragms and combined.
I think a lot of money right now is spent on medical care, and if you could prevent that on a population basis, you could definitely reduce healthcare costs. Women's health, it's almost half the population. So there's different hormonal things that affect women differently. I think some of the different nutritional aspects can help impact different policies or nutritional recommendations or even just treatment guidelines. A lot of the treatment guidelines that they have tend not to be recommendation-based sometimes. So actually having the research to back up the recommendations can help. Even here, we've started doing some things with probiotics and looking at different things that you could use kind of as a naturopathic way. I find it interesting figuring out what the results, the data shows, and you can look at different things. Whereas for some of the lab sciences, you're focused on like one area, whereas the epidemiology, you can look at a number of different things at the same time. I guess my advice would be just try different things. So if you don't think you'd like it, try it. You might end up finding you enjoy it. I think just exposure to a bunch of different things helps. Science can be fun. There's all kinds of different sciences that you can do. So it's not just reading a textbook or doing the experiments that your professor or teacher has you do. Thank you.